हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द सेकेंड क्लास ऑफ द रिमेडियल बायोलॉजी वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डायवर्सिटी ऑफ द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स, राइट। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द डायवर्सिटी मींस इट्स द नेटवर्क वन ऑफ द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम। वी कैन नॉट इवन इमेजिन दैट व्हाट इज द टाइप ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम दे एग्जिस्ट इन टू द अर्थ, राइट। सो दैट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ इट हैपन इन टू द बायोलॉजी, राइट। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट डायवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग वर्ल्ड, व्हेन वी कंसिडर वेस्ट एरिया लाइक से फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉरेस्ट, राइट, और इन एनी डेजर्ट और इन द प्लांटेरिया, वी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया व्हेन वी कंसिडर, वी फाइंड दैट द नंबर एंड काइंड ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम इंक्रीज मेनी फोल्ड, राइट। वी कैन नॉट सी लाइक राइट फ्रॉम द एंट, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम, बैक्टीरिया, फंगी, इंसेक्ट्स, एनिमल्स, स्नैक्स, रेप्टाइल्स, वर्टिब्रेट्स, इनवर्टिब्रेट्स, द वेस्ट वेराइटीज इट देयर मे बी इट हैव, राइट। सो दैट इज कॉल्ड डाइवर्सिटी, ओके। सो दीज डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स एंड अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर रिफर्ड टू एज बायोडाइवर्सिटी of this earth, right? So different kingdom they are going to form, and in their kingdom there are lots of species, lots of varieties it is going to have. That's what it is called diversity, biodiversity, living things having more number or more varieties, let me say, right? So number of various kind of organism found on earth, right? Like say when we try to understand the specific word, this biodiversity, bios means life, diversity means form, what, how many forms they are going to have, that we are going to discuss, right? So here five kingdom of classification that is very famous when it comes to the biology, right? All the living organism, it is divided into these five category. First one is the Monera, then Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. Monera means bacteria and other microorganisms. Protista means the amoeba types of organisms. Fungi means like mushroom and all those, right? Plantae means all the plants varieties, and Animalia means lion and other animals which comes under. So accordingly we are trying to divide all the living organism in these five kingdoms, right? So what is the important here, the nomenclature, right? How we are going to give the name, like say for example now new coronavirus has come up, right? So first we need to understand the virus anatomy and physiology, and based on its characteristic we are going to put them into the particular field, cellular and what kind of it is. So that's what we have to give the name, right? So naming the living organism of the world has generated a process, it is called a nomenclature, right? We have to give what may be the genus, what may be the species, that has to be given by the based on its characteristic, right? And based on this nomenclature, identification supposed to be done, like we are assigning a specific name to end the organism, right? That and wherever this name, it will be accepted universally worldwide, and wherever you go it will be, say for example the Mangifera indica, it is the mango. Mangifera is the genus and the indica is the species. So Mangifera indica, it will be whenever you will say, anybody will come to know that you are talking about the mango, right? Because it has been named already, name and nomenclature has been done in previous, and identification also it will be based on its name, right? So likewise we are trying to simplify the organisms, living organisms present into the entire world. That's what it's very important, that is called biodiversity. Thank you.